First, I need to load the space colony itself. So here we go. Vote picket. Now, it takes a while to load. It is a large object. I have it orbiting Luna at this time, as it was the easiest way to launch it, since there's no way to actually have it built in orbit. You have to launch it from a terrestrial body. I'm going to load a fairly standardized three-stage rocket. One very large apex-like lower first-stage engine, then an aerospike secondary engine, and then lastly a nuclear third engine for the command module. I'm going to accelerate the time because I want to have a daylight launch. And now we're getting ready to go. So sit back and get prepared. Thrusters up, check angle, and launch. Lots of power. This launch was handled in the beta version. So some textures are missing, but functionality is still there. We will speed things up, getting ready to get into orbit. Second stage burn. Set the orbit. A final kick to circularize the orbit and get ready for lunar insertion. Setting up for the lunar injection. So I need to find out where it's going to be when I need it. So it's usually a little bit off to the counterclockwise in this case, probably maybe 30 degrees, so that's what I'm aiming for. And now I just simply extend, adding more delta V, finding out where the orbit is, and then check to see if that is correct. Minimize the delta V so that I can use as little fuel as possible. And set it up. Now I'm setting up for an automatic burn. This is one of the nice advantages of SimpleRockets 2. That automatic burn is really nice. It saves a lot of trouble. Automatic. So far I haven't had any real problems with it. It does the job well. Some minor tweaking. Showing the ship in relation to Droo. As you can see, it's coasting nicely to Luna. Showing how everything looks. A quick amount of time acceleration. Now setting up to orbit Luna. So we have to cut some of the delta V in the injection phase. And now setting up for that orbit. There we go. So now we get ready to get into a similar orbit as the colony itself. Well, we use the last of the fuel and then stage. Now we're going to use the nuclear engine take care of the rest of the maneuvers to the colony. Continuing the orbital maneuver. So we'll just let the nuclear engine do most of this work. The one thing about nuclear engines, they don't have a whole lot of thrust, so you have to essentially allow them to thrust for a much longer period of time. However, they have a lot of initial impulse, meaning that you can burn them for much longer. They average about 2 to 3 times more efficient than general chemical engines, so this is a viable option. And we are done. Setting up a new maneuver to get closer to Luna and the colony. What luck. I can rendezvous with the colony. That is nice. And I'll save a lot of effort and a lot of time. So now I just have to slowly make sure I can get close. Looking around 10 kilometers. That way it'll be easy to spot. Okay, we're ready. Start the burn. Now we're doing the burn itself. It's time to charge the battery. Now to do the intercept burn so that I can meet up with the colony. This will take a little bit of time. Nuclear engine again, very efficient, just not very powerful. Still burning. And down. Okay, now we should be very close to where we need to be. One last burn to get within viewing distance of the colony. Now there is one interesting thing about SimpleRockets 2 is that there's a draw distance issue. That is, it will not display anything 10 kilometers or farther. It's only a point. So what happens in my case, because I have such a large object, is that about right now it is loading the actual colony, and as you can see, it just appears there. That's the draw distance issue. So now I'm less than 10 kilometers away and trying to get to it. Even from this vantage point, it's big. It's still quite far away. However, because of its sheer size, 2 kilometers across, it's quite visible from here. Another interesting thing I found out about having this large colony is that it disappears occasionally. Or I should say it shifts. Now the actual place is still up there. It's still marked. It's just displaying it in a different location. It'll eventually correct itself. There you go. But it becomes an issue if you're trying to dock. Luckily it hasn't done it when I'm very close. It's always been on approach. As you can see here, now we're getting close to the habitat ring, and now we're going into where the settle panels would be, as we're just sliding in. Right now, there's no transparency for SimpleRockets 2, so I'm using the cargo section, just magnified large, as the habitat ring. As you can see also, I'm just using a basic panel, just extended very far, to become the solar panel array. There's actually a couple of small solar panels in the colony. As you can see, that gives the colony plenty of power for the simulation that I'm playing. The central hub in the center of the view is 100 meters across, so a little shorter than the Saturn V is tall. You also see four docking rings with a small auxiliary craft. We'll be trying to dock with one of those rings in the meantime. Getting ready to align to the docking ring. And it's starting to turn dark, so I get to try to dock in pitch black. Trying to dock in the dark is not fun. Right now there's no easy way to tell which direction you are, because the minute that you go below a meter a second, the velocity indicator disappears, and all you have to use is the sight. Factor in the fact that you don't have any light sources outside of the glow. It's hard to tell where you are in relationship, unless you go flipping back and forth between views, from the front view, side view, and so on. It is very hard to do. It is one of the detractors why I was building things more than flying, because of the fact that it is so hard to dock. Then there's the RCS issue that I have. It's hard to tell which thruster is firing sometimes. They don't also match necessarily on the keys. As you can hear the stuttering, that also is a problem, as that throws up more animation of the RCS, which might not do anything, making it difficult to gauge your velocity. After a few failed attempts trying to dock and getting frustrated, I said I'll just simply wait out, wait until I orbit, and then get back into the sun. This way, at least, then I can actually dock. Sometimes I feel that this little control ship is more of a fish, the way that the large bell nozzle flashes around as it's trying to swim through the ether of space. Up just a little low, so we'll fix that. Try to slowly climb up, make sure that I'm in the right orientation and make sure I'm in the right direction. It does take a little bit of doing. Docking again is not easy in SimpleRockets too. The magnets in SimpleRockets 2 is also a bit weird, but yeah, it works this time. Now for another game. It's not just enough that you have to be magnetically coupled with the docking ring. You also have to be ready to mate. And that's why you have the docking percentage up there. I find this irritating, because you can get upwards of 80% or 90% and still not dock. And you have to tweak it a little here, tweak a little there. I mean, it would be nice if you could just say, okay, off, and allow everything to naturally dock on its own. Not this case. Trying to get this docking ring to work took quite a long time, so you could all speed up. But it did work out. This went on for quite some time. docked. Yay. Oh, well, there you go. As you can see, docked with the other ship on a large, large space colony orbiting Luna. Now for the obligatory pullback to show what's out there. That's it for me. Go Geek signing off. Hope you enjoyed the video.